programs. In last chapter we have studied about two different types of motion, which is circular motion and rotational motion. Now today we are going to study another type of motion, which is called as oscillatory motion. Student, you know that oscillation is one of the important phenomena in the world of physics, because in our daily life we come across many examples of oscillatory motion, such as motion of a spring, motion of a pendulum of a clock, the motion of vibrating string of a violin or sitar, and we can take one example like motion of prongs of a vibrating tuning fork. This is also one practical examination. Then rocking of cradle, swinging of swing, or we can say that up and down motion of the needle of the swing machine. All these are the example every day we come across. So these type of motion are the periodic motion. It means that the particle is performing this motion in equal interval of time. It is a repeated motion. So students, this periodic motion is are of two types. One is up and down and another is to and fro motion. So in this chapter, oscillation, today we are going to study about the velocity, acceleration and displacement of a particle in the form of cosine and sine functions, which is called as the harmonics. So before we start about the simple harmonic motion, concept of simple harmonic motion, first of all we will study about the periodic motion. What is mean by periodic motion? So student, periodic motion is nothing but the motion of the particle which is repeated in equal interval of time, means set of movement which is repeated, continuously repeated after a specific time, which is denoted by capital T. And the number of oscillation of the particle is nothing but the frequency of the motion, denoted by the number of oscillation is nothing but the frequency denoted by small n. Now we will see some examples of this periodic motion. See students, if we are talking about the circulatory motion, then we can take one example like motion of the moon around the earth is one of the periodic motion. Uniform circular motion is the example of periodic motion. Okay. Then second, we can say that motion of other planets around the sun is also an example of periodic motion. Then we can say that motion of electron revolving around the nucleus is also a periodic motion. In the same way, oscillatory motion are the motion of that type where the particle displaces from the mean position, and the movement is from to and fro movement from the mean position. That is called as the oscillatory motion. So in this case of oscillatory motion, if the particle is moving along a straight line, then we can call the motion as linear simple harmonic motion. And if the particle is moving along the curve of arc of a circular path, then we can call that type of motion as angular simple harmonic motion. Okay, so students, the concept of simple harmonic motion can be explained to you by this example. Now consider that this is the wooden block. Okay, this is the wooden block, and the spring is attached to the wooden block in such a way that one of the end of the spring is attached to the rigid support and other end of the spring is attached to the wooden block. See students, there are three examples are given here, three conditions are given here, in which, in first condition, the string is in the stretched position. In second condition, spring is in relaxed condition, or we can call it as equilibrium position. And in third case, the string is in compressed position. Now one by one we will understood all these cases. Okay, in first case, what happened? If the wooden block is stretched toward the right side, then that time what happened? If the displacement is toward the right side, then the restoring force acting on this block is acting towards the left side. So that's why it is called as the stretched state. Now in second condition, what happened, students? See, the spring is not displaces from their equilibrium position. There is no stretching or no compressing. So what we can say? So net force acting on this block is zero. F is equal to zero because there is no displacement. But in th- third condition or third case, which is nothing but the compressed case, what we can say, the block is compressed towards the rigid support. That time what happened, the spring is compressed. So the displacement of this block is towards the left side. That's why the force is acted towards the right side. So in all this first and third, in both the cases, what we can say, that restoring force is acted on the wooden block, which is denoted by F is equal to minus Kx. Okay, this K is nothing but the constant, or we can call it as force constant. And this negative sign indicates that force and the displacement both are in opposite direction. Okay, now as the block is oscillating, force is acted on the block and the force is acted towards the shifted the block towards the equilibrium position, so the block is in oscillatory motion. That's why acceleration is acted on the block. So acceleration of this block is denoted by F upon M. Okay, so as we know that F is equal to minus Kx, just we will substitute the value like this, and this term K upon M is nothing but the angular frequency. Okay, so we can write acceleration of the block as minus of omega square x. Okay, this is the concept of simple harmonic motion. Okay, now we will study next topic, differential equation of linear simple harmonic motion. Okay, we will see by using the equation of restoring force how the differential equation of SHM. Okay, now as we know that according to the concept we have cleared, we can define the SHM or linear SHM as like this. Linear simple harmonic motion can be defined as, it is one of the type of linear periodic motion in which restoring force is acted towards the mean or equilibrium position, then the magnitude of force is proportional to the displacement of the particle from the mean position. This is the definition of linear SHM. Using this definition, we know that restoring force is nothing but the minus Kx. We will mark this as equation 1. Now, according to Newton's second law of motion, we can say that F is equal to ma. We know this equation. Now, if we compare both this equation, what we can write? Just by comparing this equation, we can write the third equation as ma is equal to minus Kx. Now, students, we know that velocity of the particle denoted by displacement upon time, correct? At the same way, acceleration of the particle is nothing but the dv by dt, derivative of velocity. So if we substitute the value, then we can write acceleration as d by dt of dx by dt, and we will get acceleration as d square x by dt square. Now what we will do, we will substitute this value of acceleration in the equation 3. So we will get m into d square x by dt square is equal to minus kx. Now if we substitute this m towards, shift this m towards another side, we will get the equation d square x by dt square is equal to minus of k upon m into x. Okay, now as we have seen earlier that k upon m is nothing but the angular velocity or angular frequency, so we can write this term minus of k upon m. Instead of this term, our equation we can write it as d square x by dt square is equal to minus of omega square into x, where omega is equal to angular velocity. So another way we can write it as d square x by dt square, just shifting this term, we we can write plus omega square x is equal to 0. So for this case we can say that all these equations, whatever we have written, all these equations are called as the differential equations of linear SH. Okay, so in this way we have seen differential equation of linear SHM as d square x by dt square plus omega square x is equal to 0. So student, in this way today we have completed the topic up to differential equation of linear SHM. In next lecture we will study about the acceleration, velocity and displacement of SHM. Thank you.